With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hello dear students, let us read the question. Choose the correct alternative. First is, acceleration due to gravity increases or decreases with increasing altitude. So, in the first part, I am making the Earth of radius capital R. Okay, this is the center, and at this point, A point at the surface of the Earth, so it is having an acceleration due to gravity G. Okay, so now at a particular altitude, so taking this much altitude, that is at a height h, okay, above the surface of the Earth, a point is B, so you have to find out this acceleration due to gravity. It will decreases or increases with the height h, with the altitude h. So I can write the relation between g and g dash and height h. Okay, so this is the relation square. Okay, now if h is very very small compared to the radius of the Earth, so I can write here g dash is equals to g 1 minus 2 h by r. Okay, now if we increase the altitude, that is h increases, this whole factor decreases, and subtracting it from 1, so it will definitely get decreased. Okay, so g dash will decreases. So acceleration due to gravity decreases with increasing altitude. Now coming to the second part, acceleration due to gravity increases or decreases with increasing depth. So now for the second part, I am making the Earth of radius capital R. Okay, here A is the point on the surface of the Earth where acceleration due to gravity is g, and at a particular depth small d, I am making the sphere. Okay, so at this sphere, that is I have taken the point B. Okay, so you have to find at point B the acceleration due to gravity. At B, I have taken the acceleration due to gravity as g dash. So now what is the relation between this acceleration and the normal acceleration, that is at the surface of the Earth, and the depth? So this is the relation. So here we can see that by increasing this depth, so g dash will get decreased. Okay, so students, I can mark the correct one, that is acceleration due to gravity decreases with increasing depth. Okay, here Earth, we have assumed that Earth is to be sphere of uniform density. Okay, so rho will remain constant. Here I can write that rho remain constant. Now part C, acceleration due to gravity is independent of the mass of the Earth or mass of the body. So I can write the formula for acceleration due to gravity, which is equal to gm by r square. Okay, where m is the mass of the Earth and r is the radius of the Earth. So here small m, that is the mass of body, will have no effect on the g. Okay, so I can take the correct option here, independent of the mass of the body. Last question, the formula minus gmm 1 by r2 minus 1 by r1 is more or less accurate than the formula mg r2 minus r1 for the difference of potential energy. Okay, between the two points r2 and r1, that is distance away from the center of the Earth. So for the last option, I can make here that suppose this is the earth where whole mass is concentrated at this point. So in this gravitational field at a particular distance r, here is a point A. Okay, so for this, for finding the potential energy, that is U, at point A, what is the formula? Minus G M M by R. Okay, where M is the mass of the earth and small m is the this particle, okay, which is placed at this point A, and R is the radius from the center of the earth. Okay, now in the question, from the center of the earth we have two points, okay, which is placed at a distance R2 and R1. So now I am modifying this figure here. Again, mass of the earth is concentrated at O, and at some distance R1, here a point is A, okay, having mass M, and this particle is again displaced to this point B, which is at of distance R2 from the center of the earth. So you have to find the potential energy, okay, potential difference of the potential energy between the two points. Okay, so finding the potential energy, we can use this formula. So difference of the potential energy, that is UV minus UA, is equals to minus GMM. What is UB? R2. Okay, and here minus, again minus GMM by R1. Okay, if we take minus common and GMM also common, what is left? 1 by R2 minus 1 by R1. This is our answer. So it matches with this. So I can say that this formula is more accurate. Okay, is more accurate than this formula. Okay, students, thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.